Popcorn Junkies are back, reviewing Lizzie. This was a trailer that we saw starring Chloë Sevigny and starring
Kristen Stewart.
What's her most famous? She's Twilight, isn't she?
Yeah.
She's the whole vampire Twilight thing with that strange male actor. Lizzie, it's directed by Craig William Macneill, who directed a film called The Boy, which I didn't see. Have you seen it?
Yeah, I've seen it.
Is it a horror film?
Yeah.
It's about the folk tale, but based in truth, true story of Lizzie Borden. And I've got the nursery rhyme here.
Oh, do it.
So, shall we do it? Lizzie Borden took an axe and gave her mother 40 whacks. When she saw what she had done, she gave her father 41.
Whoa.
Okay, so yeah, this is about the rather violent murder of, well, her father and stepmother back in the late 1900s in Massachusetts. And so Chloë Sevigny plays Lizzie Borden. Kristen Stewart plays the maid.
Yeah.
When it started, I thought, brilliant. What was the first scene? What were we looking at? Do you remember?
Well, just the bodies of her stepmother and father.
Yeah.
Not her killing them.
No.
But after she killed them.
Yeah.
Which was quite, yeah, it was really graphic. I wasn't expecting it to be so.
No. It was quite graphic. And I mean, their heads were properly destroyed.
Especially the dads.
Because, well, he got the one extra whack, didn't he? So we started in this great way, and then I thought it did something really clever, which was in a very sort of slow, almost reconstruction way. They showed us the minutes leading up to what eventually we realised was their death.
At first, I didn't mind how it was quite slow. Felt like it was kind of building up to something, but then it went on for ages.
It did, didn't it?
The slow pace.
Yeah, it got slower and slower.
Yeah, it just got slower and slower. So at one point I was just a bit like, I kind of want to know what you're building up to now.
Yeah.
But like you said, we'd already seen at the very beginning the outcome of her having killed them.
Yeah.
So we were sitting through this really slow film and then we were thinking, but we know what's going to happen.
Yeah, I suppose the only part of the process you don't fully know, although it's suggested obviously in the nursery rhyme, the film, I think, the director would probably argue he's playing with our expectation that was it Lizzie Borden, or was it, as we discover, she develops essentially a love affair, doesn't she? A relationship with the maid. I think the film maybe is more about what were the conditions behind the killing, but yeah, it kind of showed us too much too soon.
Yeah.
I feared.
Yeah.
But once you've had
we obviously knew that they were going to die.
Yeah.
But when you're sitting through a film that slow,
you
are just a bit like, do I really need to? Because I know that she actually killed them because of the folktale.
It reminded me a little bit of, but slower, of Alias Grace.
Oh yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
It was a bit like that.
Yeah, I mean, I think this film is very much, it's also co-produced by Chloë Sevigny, which is quite telling because she's in it virtually all the way through.
Yeah,
I'm not suggesting that's why, but it's very much her film. It's very much her face in extreme close-up. Now, I am one of the biggest Chloë Sevigny fans on the planet. I mean, you know, as far as I'm concerned, you can do no wrong. There's something about it that is, well, just very unique.
All right, okay.
Anyway, and I thought at the beginning I was very excited because I don't know if you remember, there were a couple of scenes where she was having sort of fits. I mean, she's got a mental illness or a physical illness, hasn't she?
Yeah. But she's like sitting in a theater and then it's like this really long shot of her kind of enjoying it.
Yes. Yeah, and you looked at me like,
what?
Yeah, but there was
it
was cool. There was a kind of excitement because I thought, and then there was another scene not long after that where there were these moments where the camera would hold her in extreme close up. And something would happen to her jaw and her teeth.
Yeah. She was good at that.
She was great at
that. But then we said that they almost dropped it.
Yes.
That there was nothing.
Yes.
It played no part in her killing them or.
No.
Yeah.
You know, you could argue that this film is trying to tease us down a garden path to perhaps thinking that Kristen Stewart's character's done it. What did you think of her father and her stepmother?
I didn't think the stepmother was all that bad, but I suspect she killed her because she's the stepmother and, you know, it's not your real mum. The dad...
I love that she's not your real mum, just take an axe to her.
Yeah. The dad...
Yeah, come on, let's sit this.
Okay, so he was pretty disgusting
with the
sort of things that he did.
Yeah.
But I didn't think he was that bad to axe him in the face. He probably was, but what I'm saying is that he needed to be more evil.
I know what you mean.
He had a few evil moments.
Yes.
But For me, it didn't feel evil enough.
I didn't feel he was...
A few telling offs.
Yeah, a few tellings off. Well, I mean, an awful scene with him and the maid, obviously, when he goes upstairs and...
Oh, that was disgusting. But I mean, with Chloë Sevigny.
No, absolutely. Yeah, so from Chloë Sevigny. Well, I suppose when, you know, this is a spoiler review, but when it gets to the point where Chloë Sevigny kind of fully knows... What's that lovely line when he says you're an abomination?
Oh, she goes, now we're on the same page.
Yeah, I think you're right. There was a real disconnect between how bad he was. I mean, don't be around a bush. He does horrible things.
No, he does. He does. I'm not saying that he wasn't bad.
No.
But I'm saying, I just felt like, as a film,
yeah,
you need to go a step further. He needed to be more for us to understand why she would want to kill him like that.
Yeah.
But I guess because she loved Kristen Stewart,
yes,
and he'd been doing that to her,
yeah,
she would have, it would have caused more anger. I guess in a way it was kind of clever because, you know, when you get that thing when... For example, if you or mum have told me off in the past, like really loudly, and there's that thing where you go upstairs, you're like, I just want them to die!
Yeah.
So I guess it's like that, but the step
right.
too far.
What do you think of the idea that this is being called, and always has been championed as a sort of feminist folktale and a feminist film? Do you think that tag comes from the simple act of killing a man?
I think that's really wrong, actually.
Yeah, I mean, I wonder that, you know. Does it have to be feminine?
Because my problem is just because a woman is going to be a main character does not mean it's a feminist story.
Yes. I mean, you could argue that it's because of the sort of the low-level patriarchal male control of the family.
Yeah, but if a man killed a woman, nobody would be saying that that's supporting men.
Right. Yes, I see what you mean.
Just
because
a woman
mean.
Call it killing a man, if that was like... A male character, if Chloë Sevigny's character was a man, and he killed his mother and father, everybody was like, oh my god, what an awful story. But because it's a woman, it's like, what strong female character.
That's interesting.
It bothers me when it's like that.
Well, so what did you think of their relationship, Lizzie and, Chloë Sevigny and Kristen Stewart? I really believed it.
I believed Kristen Stewart.
I'm with you, even though I'm...
And she managed to make me believe the relationship.
Yeah.
But I didn't believe it from Chloë Sevigny's
That's interesting.
Part.
Do you think...
I felt she was a bit expressionless.
So she tried to play Lizzie in a way that was sort of a bit more manipulative, a bit more...
Yeah, I felt like she was doing it more to just annoy her dad.
Yes.
Really feel like there was a proper...
But with that thought in mind, does that explain more, perhaps? Do you think perhaps it was a film about how she's manipulated everyone? Not manipulated, I mean, she's, you know... She loses the plot and she axes at everyone, but she's kind of only used Kristen Stewart rather than...
Yeah.
Do you think?
Yeah.
So that in a way, she's almost as bad as her dad. Well, anyway, so the film moves very, very slowly, and I have to say, I thought it was challengingly slow. I did think it could have been tightened up. But there were a few details that were really bloody annoying. Like, there's a scene where, because Chloë Sevigny doesn't like what's going on upstairs between Kristen Stewart and her father, understandably, what does she do?
So she, like, smashes one of her mirrors.
Yeah.
And she lays the glass outside Kristen Stewart's door so that when the dad comes out, he steps on the glass.
Yeah.
So we see her do that and then she goes back to bed and we just see her face kind of waiting, I guess. And there's no sound of like a scream of the dad.
No, there's nothing.
There's no crunch of him stepping on the mirror and he's not limping for the rest of the film.
And even then, I think we cut to something in the morning. There's no look between them even.
No, there's no...
Like, because he would have known something, wasn't it? You know.
So weird.
Yeah, so there was...
It was quite good. I was like, oh, yeah.
Yeah.
It in front.
Yeah, that was a good moment. It sort of felt like a moment where, oh,
nothing
okay.
happened.
I mean, I have to say, virtually nothing happens in this film. I mean, I suppose I was expecting, you know, insane asylums. I was thinking she was going to be sent off to a sort of an asylum or something.
Yeah.
I don't think for a minute they're suggesting that her sort of frustrated sexuality is why she killed. I think it's much more about she wanted to be free of a controlling father.
And she used it as a way of...
Yeah, exactly. And I think, for me, if there was a real kind of plus to this film, it was the Kristen Stewart. I think you're right.
She was brilliant.
Yeah, it made me like her. It made me look at her differently.
She was really, really good. Obviously, we see Chloë Sevigny walk around very naked quite some time.
Yeah, you do.
For quite some time. So yeah, she kills the mother first, naked, because apparently, if she'd killed the stepmother first, that means she inherits the money.
That's right.
And that's why the dad's brother gets confused. He's like, it's strange that the killer would kill the stepmother first. She was like, oh, maybe the killer has my interests at heart.
Yes, that's right.
But yeah, so she kills the stepmother first. And then we see Kristen Stewart getting naked.
Yes.
And she goes towards the dad.
Yes, to kill him.
To kill him. Because obviously this was what they'd agreed to do. And Kristen Stewart, she kind of can't do it. Like, she pauses and she's like really good in that scene.
Yeah, she's very good.
And the dad's just like, put it down, da da da. Chloe comes, takes it off of her and just acts as the dad, but with her clothes on.
Yes.
Defeated the whole point. So her clothes have blood on them anyway.
And I suppose
Kristen Stewart was really good in that scene where she was watching Chloe smash her dad's head up.
Yeah.
You kind of saw that. Well, oh my God, who am I in love with?
Yeah, that sort of moment when you look at your partner and you go, what on earth did I see in you?
Yeah, she was really, really good though.
I think it almost...
It was just way too long. I feel like if it was shorter, it wouldn't
be that bad. I agree.
Just the length and the slowness really.
And I have to take a little bit of a sort of... I have to sort of flag up the fact that I was a little bit disappointed with Chloe. I thought she was actually very good when she wasn't saying much. I think her face in repose can do, she's a great under actor.
See, even I had a problem with her face when she wasn't. I'm gonna be honest, I just did not believe anything she was saying.
Oh, Christ.
Like when she was saying it, I didn't believe that she, the only bit I believed was when she killed the stepmother. I think when he kills her pigeons.
And I think structurally, the...
And that was horrible. He kills the pigeons and feeds them to
her. Oh, that was a good scene.
That was nasty. Like you grabbing toffee and beheading her and then feeding her to me.
Yeah, you probably want to axe my head in there.
Yeah.
So maybe he was bad enough to be axed in.
No, but I feel like the actor, he could have been more evil between all of his doings.
Well, my major Achilles heel for this film is I think they made a mistake in showing us at the very beginning of the film.
But at the beginning we were like, ooh.
Yeah, yeah, because I suppose, I don't know what I thought. I thought we were going to...
I thought it was
going to
be shorter.
But I suppose I thought we were going to have an ever spiraling development of drama towards this sort of crescendo of I can't bear it. And in a way, I think it does do that, but the emotions are so pushed beneath the surface that everyone sort of, you know, and I guess it's the time, I guess it's the era, everyone was sort of like in a basque and absorbed everything. And so you're right, even Chloe's expression, the father, Fiona Shaw, they were all, you know, differently good in different ways, but it was just buttoned up.
Like even, because like when the dad came into the house, for example, or when he was in the house, I never felt that kind of like tense feeling, which I did feel in Thoroughbred.
Yes,
where the dad isn't necessarily evil, he's just a bit of a...
That's a good point. Fundamentally, I'm a little bit disappointed with Lizzie. We went in with high expectations, Chloe, but it delivered Kristen Stewart to us. So in sum up, what would you say in sum up and give us a score?
So yeah, I was really disappointed with Chloe Sevigny's performance. I don't think I've seen her in anything else though. I felt like the dad needed to be a lot more evil.
Yes.
I felt his brother was more evil than him.
Yes.
I really, really like Kristen Stewart after watching that film.
Yeah, I did.
So I want to give her like other films a go.
Yeah, yes. Yeah,
not Twilight though. Never. No. The deaths were really well done, like the makeup and everything. It was just too slow. It was too long. I did find it a little bit boring after a while because it didn't get any further than the death. I'd probably rate it like a 5 out of 10.
Okay. For me, it was a good opportunity to get to grips with Kristen Stewart. She impressed me. Chloe Sevigny, a big disappointment. It was hitting all the wrong notes. I felt it was slightly out of step. It thought it was one thing, didn't quite know what it was. I think it made a few structural mistakes. There were a few structural omissions, such as, you know, the moment with the broken mirror. And so that sense of a building, ever-tightening tension just wasn't there for me. Yeah, the biggest question mark was, to what extent did Lizzie do it, or did, you know, Kristen Stewart's character do it? But by the end, it kind of didn't really matter.
Yeah.
I think it could have either been more of a... they could have made it more of a psychological portrait. So a disappointment. I think we're on the same page with this one. I'll give it 5 out of 10 too.
Yeah.
Sounds very unoriginal. I keep giving the same scores as Maddie, but she kind of nails it, I think. So Lizzie Borden took an axe and gave her mother 40 whacks. When she saw what she had done, we gave this film just a 1.
For more film and family fun, don't forget to click the subscribe button and make sure to click the bell to never miss an update.